interrupt you to bring you a special broadcast from King Boris.
Give me the wrong cards you gave me, scanner. Sorry. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's performance of Rapunzel. Right, I must go down to some business, so if there's a fire, please run, but don't run. Walk to the closest exit. There. Please, no mobile phones. If you hear a ping, then you should not put a microwave with you. Please, no flash call. However, I can send you a link to my OnlyFans account after performance. Before I hand it over to my witty assistant over here, who shall explain the plan for this evening, I simply must explain this to you. There are no disasters, just opportunities. And indeed, opportunities for fresh disasters. Thank you.
Thank you, King Boris. And just like Golden Water Park, next slide, please. Is he gone? Oh, thank goodness for that. Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to the Wyvernhoe Pantomime. Yay! I am your witty narrator. You know, people often ask me, isn't it hard being a narrator, knowing everyone's waiting for you to get your lines over so you can get on with the opening number and the rest of the show? And you know, it can be, but I take pride knowing that I am the most important character of every pantomime. Without me, you'd have no story. Without me... excuse me, I'm trying
to... Okay. So, that's great song, and we can't wait to get started, so...
Well, what is it? Well, that is quite good. One of my favourites, actually. Okay, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. The story is set in the village of Wyvernhoe. This is the story of Rapunzel.
Hit it!
Yeah.
think I'm the brains of our family, especially since Dad left. Aww. But it's worse than that! Aww. I want to get a proper job and provide for us. We're so poor, we don't have Sky TV. We just look at the sky for entertainment. We're so poor, we want to go burgers, and the burglar left us a gift basket. We're so poor, we leave IOUs for the Tooth Fairy. Aww. I tell you what would cheer me up. You can help when I come on stage. If I say, hello everyone, can you all shout, we love you, Mom? Do you think you can do that?
Yeah.
Let's give it a try. Hello everyone.
Hello.
Thank you. That was really motivational. That's my mum. Well, it could be my dad. No, it's 100% my mum. Dame Bimini. She's a bit of a handful, especially now she's expecting a baby. Oh, it's so exciting to think that very soon I'll have a little brother or sister to play with. Alright, keep your bump on. Anyhow, she's been acting very weird of late. Got all these food cravings, but not normal cravings like when I want chips and kebabs from Henley's and Tollgate Fisheries after a night out. The Horse and Groom, the Greyhound, the Rose and Crown, the Station, and the Black Boy. And Chip Chip and Pop Mitchell's done. Tick! No, Mum's cravings are for healthy food. Ugh. And salad. Ugh. Which, if you know her, is completely out of character. Unless it's fermented grapes, that is. I want to help, but it's the middle of winter and there's no salad to be found anywhere thanks to snow and ice and Brexit. I do have pitch. It disappears. I don't know where it goes. Do you know where it goes?
Yeah.
I'm surprised Donald Trump hasn't tried to use it. Please do not leave near exposed flames or even radiators or hot water bottles. Mum, if we offer this, they're going to think we're threatening them. Chicken!
Yummy!
Let me tell you all about it!
homegrown tomatoes.
Boris!
Puny mortal!
Well, you see,
Anyway, I ought to turn you into a great crested newt, or maybe something more endangered.
Please don't hurt me. We were going to give you a bottle of that in return for you run around.
Lethal death fluid? Oh, 2020, a good year. For disgusting homemade concoctions, you may as well have given me some banana bread. Prepare to meet your maker.
I'm really sorry. I'll put them all back. I'll make it up to you.
You will you? Very well. You can have all of these from your mum with my blessing as often as you like. If you do me one teensy, weensy little favour.
Anything.
As soon as your sister is born, you give her to me. I turn you and your mum into earwigs right now.
But why?
Let's just say your sister is destined for higher things. Sorry, nervous response. But really, your choice is give her to me or die horribly, horribly.
You're a witch. This is Wyvernhoe after all. You don't exactly stand out.
Buddies!
Put it like that, it's a deal.
Promise?
Promise? Mum's gonna kill me!
Oh, that's your problem! Right, well, take these. And you may as well have this. I've been teetotal from lethal death fluid since that night out in Clacton in 1986. But I see you in a few months' time. Soon, I will have all of the ingredients for my spell to make me invincible. And I will be the most powerful evil witch in the universe! Ah, wait a minute! Who are you?
Banana!
Dead, living, fictional, or animated, who've come to volunteer our services as your new henchman.
Oh. Henchman? Well, you don't look very hench. What's your names?
I'm Simon.
I'm Keith.
And he's Bill.
Bill.
Well, what are your credentials?
I once hench for a tin of a honey monster who is real sweetie.
I was just going to tell her that I was a mini-me for Dr. Evil.
References!
Right here.
Never employ these idiots.
Very ridiculously, ludicrously cheap.
Well, why don't
I'm calling on the site. Deserves a warning. I'm dangerous. Appalling. There's no escape from your fate. That you can stop. And since many songs are dangerous, but no one
Let's
lettuce rejoice. Oh, yummy, yummy salad, come to Mama.
Mother, what are you doing?
Why, I'm tossing my salad, of course, darling. Are you feeling okay? I'm holding a frying pan and you're not even cowering. You look like something's on your mind.
Oh, no, I don't.
Oh, yes, you do.
Oh, no, I don't.
Oh, yes, you do.
Oh, no, I don't.
Oh, yes, you do.
I'm perfectly fine. Oh, well, why is the bush shelter all that? I think I'll go to bed. Mum?
What's that?
Nothing.
The months flew by. And Dame Bimbi gave birth to a beautiful baby girl.
Baby in return, so just hand her over to me and I won't turn you both into earwigs.
One second. How do I even know that you're a witch? I have a broom, but I don't go around threatening people and saying I'm going to steal their babies.
Buddies!
Plus... I've got a text message saying I have to isolate for 3 months! Now mine says 6 months! 1 year! Okay, stop! I can see we're in a bit of a pickle.
Pickle.
Oh, what do I do? If I don't give her the baby, then she's going to turn us into earwigs. But if I do give her the baby, then... what do I do? I don't know. What should I do?
Give her the baby.
Give her the baby.
Give her the baby.
Okay, well, based on that logical explanation, I'd better give her the baby. But I demand to see her on her birthday every year.
Why should I agree?
Because I can be very, very persistent and very, very annoying. Just ask wife and how to tell Kettle about me. You may be all powerful and magical, but I can make sure that your bins don't get collected.
Actually, how would she notice the difference?
If I agree, well, you must never tell her you are her real mother. Oh. Agreed. Oh, stay out of this, Bob. It's done. Thank you.
Come on now, my beauty. Look, her hair's already starting to grow. Soon. There'll be enough to make me all powerful!
Hi, Bob. Could you get me a chair? I'm feeling a bit faint, Mum. This is all my fault. You must hate me. I don't hate you. I love you. Somebody has to. We're not letting that horrible witch take both of my children. We're going to come up with a plan. Starting this day. Next year.
Hooray!
But how? Well, we'll make the plan up as we go along. I mean, that's what the script writer's been doing anyway, haven't you, Hazel?
And so, Wicked Witch Grimalda took Baby Rapunzel to her lair, where she used her powerful magic to construct a high tower. But just what was her foul purpose? Tune in to Scene 4 to find out. Deep in the heart of the forest, this magnificent structure holds a deep purpose.
What, you again? We've got a home to go to.
Bob's not here.
Oh, lovely. As I was saying, she's always around here spying on all the design creatures. Bit of a weirdo, if you ask me.
Well, I'd see better when you didn't talk. You just shut up and try and tell the story.
I got
caught her spying on her very years ago, just trying to go about its business. She made excuses about looking for Goldilocks.
Look, I'll give you a carrot, but you go away.
Bribery, is it? Okay, five carrots.
Done. As I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, Grimelda took Baby Rapunzel to her lair in the woods, where she spent her childhood up there in the clouds in the tower, with only the birds, Aunt Grimelda, and Dame Bimini once a year on her birthday. Over time, she grew to be a beautiful young woman, with a serious case of lockdown hair.
You're still here? Go on, sit you up.
Oh, it's a beautiful day. The birds are singing, the sun is shining. I just wish I could be out there with them. I know Auntie Grimelda cares for me. She told me how she took me in when my parents abandoned me. I just wish she wasn't so protective of me, and that she'd let me out of this car wash, and that she'd let me get a haircut. This is getting ridiculous. Ah, that's your horse. What are you doing?
Just a little bit. For my nest.
Oh, of course. Help yourself. It's not like I'm really sure.
I'm a magpie, by the way. But my friends call me Pascal. I mean, Glasgow. No reference to Disney. At all. Pleased to meet you. Did you know it's good luck to salute a magpie every time you see one?
Oh, really?
Yeah, I know. I tell you what, how about every time I come on stage and say, hello everybody, you will say, good afternoon, Mr. Magpie, and give me a big salute. Should we try it?
Yeah.
Should we try it?
Yeah.
Get off, go. See, I'm taking your life now. Hello everyone.
Good afternoon, Mr. Magpie.
Thank you. I'm pleased to meet you, madam. You have beautiful soft hair.
Thank you. I'm delighted to make your acquaintance. My name's Rapunzel. I'm getting a bit sick of my hair, to be honest, so get stuck in.
Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Let down your hair!
Alright, alright. You best hide. She doesn't like visitors here.
Rapunzel! Your hair!
Pull it down!
Sure, this gets longer every day.
Ow! That hurt!
Sorry! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear Rapunzel! Oh, here you are, Finny Boots.
Oh, I completely forgot it's my birthday. How about it? Some lettuce, squishy tomatoes, and slightly mildew celery. How thoughtful.
It's the least I could do.
Aunt Carola, I was wondering, seeing as it's such a beautiful day outside, and it is my birthday, if I could go out.
No! I mean, why, Rapunzel? Look at you, as fragile as a flower. Still a little sapling, just a sprout. Oh, who writes this Disney rubbish? Does she look that fragile? A sprout, really? You know why we stay up in this tower. Yes, that's right, to keep you safe and sound. Yes, I guess I always knew this day was coming. Well, actually, I didn't know this day was coming, did I? Because, well, if I did know it was coming, this would be really rather a short pantomime. Something along the lines of, I've got the hair, total power, by the whole of Northeast Essex, built a huge city, I mean, garden community. And then I'd retire on the obscene profit. Yet,
but
trust me, pet, Auntie. Auntie's right here. Auntie, protect me, darling. I said yes. Kids would rather stay with me. Auntie, the best.
All right, you lot. This has gone really badly every other show, so I'm going to need your help. Sue, I'm going to have total power over the whole of Wyvernhoe. But what should I change first? Go.
Stones exceeded his remove before asking again.
Alexa, activate the winch.
be alone, but I'm sad to be alone.
That's because you haven't met enough mad people yet. Hello, everyone!
Hello,
I think we can do better than that. I said hello, everyone!
Hello,
anyhow, what's her deal with being everything like you up in this tower? You should be out dancing around your handbag, letting your hair down. No pun intended.
I'm sure she's just trying to keep you safe.
I'm not sure. Don't you think much of your birthday for small young bitch, do you? Telling you poor pipe that was scared outside welding and not letting you have visitors. I'm not sure she has your best interest at heart. It sounds to me like you need friends.
Well, I guess I could be friends of Aunt Grimalda. Although, now I'm not sure. And don't worry, although I only get to see her once a year, I never get to speak to her properly. Well, I'd like to go to her.
Well, why she makes that, I can be your friend. If you want to talk, and if you need a listening beak, a winter pile, or back massage from a kind foot under, or talk worms, maggots, or spiders, or not, Doctor's also there. And if you like your back and want to give me the Australian pen, or something shiny, I think we should be proper busy. Best friends.
Son, you have to realise, peasants aren't
like us, they are lovely, sensitive, poetic human beings with a private education. They are pests, whinging, moaning, and quite frankly smelly pests. And the sooner you learn that, the sooner you'll be ready to be king after me.
That can't be true.
Oh yes, it is.
Oh,
no, it is. Surely it is. It's worth forbidding you to leave the Fajr Palace until we sort this all out, lest you meet these dangerous creatures.
But how do I know the truth unless I leave the palace? It's about time I have an adventure. Please!
I have spoken.
Very well.
Guards!
Sire!
Hang on, you're my guards.
Where's Dominic?
Oh, a bit awkward, but he's disappeared.
Yeah, someone said he got lost his way back to Bernard Castle.
Should have got the spec favours.
So we're your guards now.
Well, if that's the case, what are your names?
I'm Guard One.
Oh, well, I guess that makes me Guard Two.
You can always be Guard Three.
No thanks.
What were your names before you were guards?
Well, we've done a lot of these gigs, and normally I'm Guard One.
And I'm Guard Two, but now I'm Guard One.
You got stuffy about it and started moaning.
Why should I always be Guard Two?
So now...
I'm Guard One.
And I'm Guard Two. Seven times Guard One.
You are?
Obviously I'm talking binary.
What's her name?
For now, let's call her you.
Who?
Exactly.
Not this again.
For goodness sake, what were your names before you were guards?
Classified information, sire.
Yeah, we'll tell you that, Mr. Cooper.
Here we are, sworn to protect you and do your bidding.
All right. Well, I want you to do my bidding now.
Yes, sire.
Keep an eye on my son. Report back to me whatever he does, and prevent him from getting into trouble.
Sir, yes, sir!
Dismissed. If I know that duck-hearted son of mine...
Which one?
Shut up! If I know my only legitimate son, he needs protecting from himself. Guards, call my hairdresser. My hair is looking far too presentable.
We could do that for you, Dyer.
What are you doing to me? Sake. Much better.
I don't care what you say. You're not the boss of me. I'll do what I want, where I want, and with whom I want. As nothing can say or do about it.
Hooray!
Good. Well, I don't care what he says. I'm going on a quest to meet into work to meet some real people. Maybe even a real princess to fall in love with. I will call it my great adventure!
Last great adventure.
amulet to ensure my success on my quest. And only for 2 gold pieces each. Bargain! I wonder who lives in this tower.
Aunt Romelda.
Do you see that lady who came up here before you?
I did. I just didn't. not sure what for. Tell me, you're from the outside world. What's it like?
It's really, really big. And you're beautiful. I mean, it's beautiful. You mean, you've never been out there?
Nope.
Not even to Varnum Castle?
No, there's nothing wrong with my outside. I haven't even been as far as the co-op.
You've been to the world of what's in the room for then.
Sorry,
I mean, why did I?
So what else can you tell me about the outside world?
I know, why can't you want adventure? I know, but it's the most amazing person I've ever met.
Oh, yuck, who writes this stuff? Scoops Carpenter?
Just you! I think I'll love you too, but I can't go. My mother would be so worried.
It's your life, only live once.
Then who's a lover boy?
I've never heard a voice in my life.
Well, it sounds like he knows you. You best get something to pretty yourself up. Go and get your best frock from the wardrobe. I'd like to meet your new boyfriend. Go!
By myself.
I need to know if Prince Philip is okay. I don't know what it is about him, but I seem to have fallen for him. Even if I only have just met him. Aww. It's so strange. This guy's been ages. Oh, I hope he comes back. I found myself and I found a boy all around the world and around the world.
Phew! That was all a bit much, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Thankfully, Prince Wilf had a soft landing, as we can see from this action replay.
What was you doing shouting at the radiator the other day?
Having a heated argument, chap.
That makes sense. Anyway, he's been up in that tower ages.
You think we should do something?
Our orders were to report back and prevent him getting into trouble.
What's that noise?
Something about.
Yes, the letter spotted. If I'm not mistaken. If you get down low and don't frighten it, it will treat you to its mating.
Is that the owl?
No, you think of boots, that idiot jumpman.
I'm sorry.
Are you okay?
Oh, I think so. I punched him past the tower, and an evil witch tried to kill me. It's been a bit of a rubbish day, really. I'm your dad, God. What are you doing here?
An evil witch, you say?
Trying to kill you, you say?
That's it, sire. We're going home.
And you're coming with us.
I'm in safety. I'm not leaving this place without Rapunzel. And you haven't answered my question. What are you doing here?
Classified information, sire.
But you say we can tell you through song.
Good point. Hit it. good anyway.
So this proposal, she's up there, right?
Yes.
There's some sort of a winch.
Why don't we just get her to pull us up? Rapunzel!
No answer. Sorry, Sam, but you know, never trust a woman.
Yeah, no bad news. You met her off with a dog or a sheep. A four-legged friend, a four-legged friend, they'll never let you down. They won't leave you after you bought their expensive birthday presents. But I'm completely over it now.
Do you need a hug or something? You can't have one. Not looking for instance, okay? Oh, fine. How about a virtual one?
Get a room.
Have you quite finished? So, I imagine I have to report back to my dad.
So, when was the last time you reported back to him?
That piece of meat, shoes, Harry, days ago.
Never!
You're not supposed to tell that.
We haven't yet.
We will, right?
So,
why don't you do it now? Tell him I've fallen in love with a beautiful princess trapped in a tower by an evil witch. And once I've sorted that out, I'll be home.
Hey. I'm not too sure if it's happy to hear that.
It's recorded back, isn't it?
He's got a point. Come on, let's go.
Fine. You will stay safe though, won't you?
Oh, of course.
All right, let's go.
Right. Let's put the problem in rationalised. I'm down here, and she's up there. Oh, there must be an answer.
Hello, everybody.
Oh.
Bubble! Bubble!
thing, I recharged my broom.
Remilda!
Oh, dear sweet boy, what an idiot you are. You'd best join the rest of them.
Ooh, hello, handsome. Who are you?
Mum, stop flirting. Oh, hello, everyone.
Hello.
At your service. I came here to try and save my daughter from the evil witch, but she was too strong for me, and I ended up in here.
And me, I followed Mum here, make a mistake.
Hang on, are you Rapunzel's mother?
Guilty as charged.
Are you Rapunzel's brother?
Yes, have you seen her?
I have, she's still trapped in the tower, but right now I need to figure out how to escape from it. Can't stop Grimelda making her spell.
I can hear you, you know. And now my broom is fully charged, well, I can destroy you in the blink of an eye.
You know what?
Uh-huh.
I am fed up with your threats. Just go ahead and destroy us if you're threatening it all the time.
Well, actually I've been thinking and it might be more fun, for me that is, if you all get to watch me eat Rapunzel before you become my slaves!
You fiend!
I don't think you can judge me. What sort of mother were you?
The sort of mother that didn't want to be turned into an earwig. The sort of mother who saw her daughter on her birthday every single year. And the sort of mother who wishes every day that she had been turned into an earwig rather than lose her daughter.
Oh, very moving. I think I just threw up a little bit in my mouth. Anyway, I'm off to go and get Rapunzel, but before I go,
seeing as my
henchmen are feeling ill, thanks to all your mawkishness, maybe just a little spell to stop you lot from, oh, I don't know, running away? From the village squire to Bedal Sassoon, I stare my pot and wave my broom. Keep these idiots in this room!
What's happening? I can't move!
Neither can we!
Oops, I shouldn't have said idiots. Don't think I didn't notice you buffoons sliding off to get chips. Oh well, go for a barge.
We're stuck to the spot! We can't even breathe!
Little suckers!
Ah!
get the lock of hair and take us to the witch's lair. Yes, take us there!
Hooray!
I wouldn't give up your day job.
Leave him alone, Mum. Maybe we just need more magic. I know, perhaps the audience can help.
Yay! Yay! The audience participation song is the most important thing in the pantomime.
Oh, they thought they could get away with it. We can teach you the word. It's really easy, I promise. If you bought a program, the word's on the back of there. And if you're too cheap for that, then we'll be up there.
Are we all ready?
Yeah!
Okay!
passengers per stick.
We have to get you out of there.
But how?
Squeaky squeak.
Not now, Bunny. I'm trying to think.
Squeaky squeak.
Allow me. I'm going to just translate, not interfere with the narrative of the story.
Squeaky squeak.
So the bunny communicated in this simple language a long time
it's
ago.
Fine. So a long time ago, the human they call Hobbity Box helped our great-great-great-great-grandfather, Mr. Hobbity, feed our great-great-great-grandfather.
Our?
We tell tales in our burrows of Hobbity Bobbin's kindness. Hobbity Bob will always be a friend of the rabbits.
Aww. We'll do all in our power to help you.
Aww. Well, it's a bit tricky, you see. We need to get that baby off that tower, but there's no way of people getting up or down.
If you can't get to the tower, make the tower come to you.
Big lads.
Peppa Pig World.
whatever you decide. I will respect your wishes.
Will I marry you? Never really thought of myself as a marrying kind.
Let's make this man show his shoes.
three schoolboys, pride and joy, and I guess it was enough for me. To win the race, a prettier face, brand new clothes, and a big fat place, and a rock and roll TV. But the way you play the game is not the same, no way. I think I'm gonna get me some happy. I think there's something you should know.
I think it's time I told you so.
There's something deep inside of me.
There's somewhere else you got to be.
Take back your picture in a frame.
Take back your picture in the rain.
I just hope you understand. Sometimes the clothes do not make a man. All you have to do now is take me out and make the truth up.
Thank you. Thank you.